Welcome back, PC World fans, for your dose of heavy hitters for this past week. Now, Intel dropped some major announcements about its upcoming graphics cards for gamers. Also, Nvidia reported some seriously impressive financials and important details around their LHR line of cards, but the CEO of the company did have some rather concerning news for us gamers in the coming months. Now, with all of that said, let's dig in. Now, you no longer have to refer to Xe, HPG, or DG2 when talking about Intel's gaming graphics cards. You can now put both of those sets of letters and numbers down and simply say Intel Arc going forward. And linked in the description is our own Gordon's full breakdown of everything we know so far. But while you're here, I'm going to give you a high-level bring up. Now, Arc is the name and gaming is, well, the game. Xe HPG is still the underlying tech, so that moniker will remain, but we've got some new details about it. We know that Arc will support ray tracing, as each of the slice of the GPU will feature dedicated hardware for accelerating that function. We also know that there will be support for mesh shaders and variable rate shading. So it seems that we are going to see a full DirectX 12 Ultimate compliant GPU. One of the more exciting features that Intel revealed was its XeSS. Now, upscaling and supersampling is all the rage, with Nvidia's DLSS killing it in the AI reconstruction scene, and AMD offering an alternative with their Fidelity FX Super Resolution feature. And Intel is getting in the game too. Their XeSS is a machine learning technique that uses motion vectors and temporal data to reconstruct higher resolutions images from a lower base resolution. It appears that XeSS will have cross-vendor support, but we'll have to wait and see just how good it is in person. There are also new code names within the Intel Arc line of GPUs. The company is kicking things off with Alchemist, then they have the Battle Mage, Celestials, and Druid. Now, I can't tell if they're massive D&D or Diablo fans, but I'll take it. There's a lot more details in the article, so please follow that link once you're done with today's video. Now, financials are always a fun topic, and who doesn't like seeing just what ludicrous amounts companies are pulling in? Nvidia's reveal of its second quarter fiscal 2022 earnings show the company is raking in megabucks from their gaming, data center, and professional visualization platforms to the tune of being up 68% from the previous year and 15% from the previous quarter. While all of that is impressive, more interesting is the amount of graphics card sales that have come from the LHR lineup. For those uninitiated, the LHR, or low hash rate cards, were designed to built in crypto curbing methods and severely hinder the card's Ethereum mining performance, as well as other algorithms. The goal was to make them less desirable for miners while they were releasing a separate CMP, or crypto mining processor. According to the reports, of the GeForce cards shipped, 80% of those were the LHR variety. That is a pretty impressive number. While that might sound super impressive, and the numbers are certainly high, in a call with CEO Jensen Huang, he talked about the supply constraints. Tech Power Up has the quote from the man himself. Meanwhile, we have and are securing pretty significant long-term supply commitments as we expand into all these different market initiatives that we've set ourselves up for. And so I would expect that we will see a supply-constrained environment for the vast majority of next year, is my guess at the moment. Now, those words don't exactly instill confidence in the idea of being able to just walk into a store and pick up a graphics card at or even near MSRP anytime soon, but it does give us something very real to think about. Now, this week has been an interesting mix of news from the unexpected to the unwanted, and if you're like me, then you got a nice surprise from Intel with them finally pulling the curtain back a bit further on their upcoming line of gaming graphics cards. We also got to see how incredibly well Nvidia is performing from a financial side, but more importantly, finally got to see some numbers on how those LHR cards are actually being shipped. But all of that came with the grim news that we can expect supply constraints through next year from Nvidia at the very least. And that's it for this week's Major News Roundup. If you think we missed something major that you want the world to know about, feel free to share it in the comment section. And if you enjoyed this roundup, let us know by hitting the like button and make sure that you're subscribed with that notification bell rung as well so that you don't miss all the future PC hardware news and more.